Yes. We need to move. Give me his body. I'm putting it in the fire. I'm putting your body in this fire. Hey guys, welcome back to the Radiation Zone, guys. I'm somewhat radiated, guys, just in case you guys didn't already know. And today we are going to be playing some Mafia 3. I haven't had a chance to play this. I know it's been out a minute, guys, but, you know, I'm a little late to the party, as usual. Especially with, you know, a whole bunch of other things going on in my everyday life, as you guys probably already know. So, yeah, I wanted to jump into it and try to play some of this and see what I could do. So here we go.
Lankin's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father was white, maybe even Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you looked black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
Well, when did you meet Lincoln Click?
1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
He was a quiet boy. Good boy.
Two Purple Hearts, a Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approve, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home. Always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it in the army. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money, and he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Wow. That's just crazy. Alright. So we got a little bit of a backstory there on kind of the history of what's going on. So, what is this? An armor truck? We robbing this?
Still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here.
Using real money to rob somebody. What? Alright.
Hey man, grab those keys.
I'm working on it, bro. You wanna see me heading that way? Chill your roll. Okay, A obviously is not the right button to get inside. X. Oh, you gotta hold it.
Still not.
That's
sure
kinda weird.
Leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck just like he asked. He greased his partner to make it look good. You got doubts, why take the chance?
What am I doing? So I can pick him up? Alright, let's take him. Well, I don't know if I'm supposed to take him with us, but I am taking him.
We should get going. Mm-hmm. You got the keys, so you can drive.
Come on, let's get
the
hell out of here.
Okay, cool. Here, we'll throw him down then. How do I jump? How do I do things? Why can't I not drive? Oh, I gotta come out the door? Really? Okay. I'm stupid. Don't mind me!
Move on. Let's go.
Is there anything else around here I could pick up? Probably not. Get in.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses.
Okay, well, this is cool, though. It's like
that poor fuck back there. He ain't got no idea what he's in for.
What was his cut? 5%?
They're about, but not like he'll be able to spend it. Feds will be watching his every move for the rest of his life. Probably be better we just whack him.
If I learned anything in Nam, always a good idea to dangle someone out there. Use them to get everybody's attention, and you just slip away.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Old Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh. Come on, you going to answer the question or what?
We.
I'm trying to use
it. We're on the coast of Quang Nai. Evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting him onto a medical ship, and this woman walks up.
Whoa.
She got a baby in one hand and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were gonna tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, god damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. The conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day, you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day, everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall. They will do anything to survive.
That better be one delicious fucking pig.
That woman just jaywalked. We're the police. Okay, I guess, like, we gotta go quietly or carefully to the drop-off because we don't want to alert the police because I guess we're robbing these people. I like seeing this. This is cool. Like, I like seeing all these old classics and stuff. Dude, what are you doing running me off the road? Get in your own lane. Jeez Louise, buddy. Oops. I just shot my gun. Hope that don't hurt the coppers. Do we get to have our own vehicles and stuff? I heard this is kind of like Grand Theft Auto, in a sense. Buddy, get out of the way. I gotta drive this long drive. Whoa, look at all the scenery, man. That looks really cool. Could you guys imagine what it was like to live in this time period? Like, on the timetable, could you guys really imagine living back then? It'd be so crazy, but it would also be kind of cool, too. Like, I always loved this time period. It's, like, one of my favorite time periods in history. Like, the 50s and, like, the 80s and stuff like that. I really like those time periods. They're really interesting to me.
Dogs at the Reserve probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat.
I gotta leave my gun? Apparently. Okay. I'm making some illegal turns, but
time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
Alright. Wish I could do turn signals. Make things a little easier. Alright, here we go. Yes, we're here to make a drop-off. We got a bunch of, stupid cash that, we just don't want.
Back it up to the loading dock.
We're robbing the Federal Credit Union, with a bunch of real money.
A little rough with the language, and
well, I ain't like I never been called nigger before.
I know, but I'm just saying if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
Cause you already have money. Y'all said that at the beginning, right? That y'all were robbing this place with real money.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right.
Why are you coming in with a shotgun in your hand? That's not suspicious at all.
Now, here we go.
I'll leave my gun.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
I'll leave my gun behind. And this dude brings a shotgun.
Action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet.
I don't have a gun.
You can follow me.
Why are these guys?
For you. Go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room.
No problem.
How much y'all bring in? $238,546. Small bills mostly. I'll have Miss Gale call up to your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery. Appreciate it.
That's a lot of dough, bro. Only like a quarter of $1 million. It's no big deal. It's a small change.
Check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying room's down in the cellar. This way.
I'm going out. I'm not following you.
I've seen you around these parts before.
Okay, I will follow you. I don't know where I'm going.
He just got out.
You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you!
Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
That Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back.
I wanted to steal all that.
Doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Put those bags on the table there.
So it makes sense.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
It gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck. That's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy coming.
Yes!
Asshole. We need to move.
Give me his body. I'm putting it in the fire. I'm putting your body in the fire. Oh. It didn't work. Let me put him in the fire.
Are you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
Here. Just stick them off in the corner there. Okay, I gotta sneak up on this guard. There's two of them.
Know that house we've been renting out? Called over there last night.
Oh! That was clean. Oh, that's clean. That's what neat. Oh. Whoa, bow! Knocked out, son. That's how you do it.
Lincoln, get over here, man.
I'm here, bro. I got this. Don't worry, we're gonna rob this place for everything it's got.
Legit.
Get it.
Well, I'll be damned. Alright, go for it, Godzilla.
Huh, that's funny. Godzilla. He looks like Godzilla. Looks all beefed up and stuff.
Holy fucking shit.
Beautiful.
Alright, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch through with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
Wow. That's a lot of dough. Especially back then. Wow.
God damn it! You triggered the fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. All right, we're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling.
Hey, you gonna pull this off?
You're dumb, dude. You just go and trip the alarm, so now we have to fight our way out. You stupid moron. Already got stuff. Hey, can I grab some moonglaw? Can I grab some of this? I want some of this. Okay, guess not. I can't grab any of this. Oh, give me that back. Oh, these are locked. Whoa. Firing this is kinda a little weird. Come on! Get yourself! Catch yourself! Wow, the firing rate is kinda terrible. I'm out of ammo. Let me run back in here and grab this shoddy. Get wrecked. Let's get wrecked.
Give me a goddamn hand here. No one's taking me out yet, son. He's bleeding now.
Come on. Dude, come on, man. Get out of my way. I'll do the dang thing myself. Worthless. Yeah, I don't care. I like to figure things out as I go. Okay. Boom! Cracked it first try. Oh. Daddy lied. What's the difference between that pistol and the pistol I had? I think this one's better, probably.
I'll deal with these.
Bro, episodes. Your face is screwed up, man. What happened?
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You can take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Be as how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it. It was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your car.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
Sweet. Okay. Gotta find my home. This must be the house. I'm assuming, 'cause it's the only thing on the map. So that's gotta be it, right? Yep. Alright. Sweet ride, my boy.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama had, you know how he gets.
I'm not trying to run his car. Come on. We're cutting you off, buddy. Don't wreck into my car. We'll have problems. I'm all driving like a madman because I got a really cool car. You gotta lay low. Why is it every time I drive by a cop, he's already suspicious of me? Even if I'm doing the speed limit and I'm doing things right, he's like out for me already.
I was thinking we could go to this new club in the French Ward. Maybe double date it.
Forget driving right.
Go with your great ambitions.
Let's just go.
Oh God! I ever tell you I accidentally saw her without a shirt once? That woman has the droopiest, nastiest tits I've ever seen. They were like two sacks of potatoes with nothing in them.
Yeah, like that was a fucking accident.
Hey man, fuck you. I was damn lucky to walk away from that one. Anyway, you'll go with Regine.
Regine?
Believe me, once you see her, you're gonna wanna dig right in.
Matter of fact.
She got half the guys in the hollow sniffing around asking her out. Turns them all down. She's only got eyes for you, Lincoln Clay.
Fuck you.
Wait and see, man. One look and your pecker's gonna pop right out.
This game is so clean. That was so cool. Come on, buddy, we're here.
I ain't having your wall here. I ask you the back door.
What are you talking about?
Look who I found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Welcome back, baby.
Boy, I send you to bring Lincoln Clay home. Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did.
You're dang right.
I'm so
Rob Bank.
So proud of you. Pour Lincoln. Bienvenue à la maison.
Pour Lincoln. Bienvenue à la maison.
Good to see you.
You're so good.
Nice seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
Woo! Man, whiskey's going hoy in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as you left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you want to crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.
Alright, let's go to bed then. Wake up fresh and relaxed and... So Sammy's, it must be like our home for now? A temporary home until we get money to buy a place of our own. That's what I'm thinking. So... Nightmares. From the war times. Alright. Alright guys, well, I'm gonna wrap up this episode here. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, guys, make sure, as always, you smash that likes button for me, guys. If you are new to my channel, guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well. And I will see you guys in the next video. This, and kill off Joel. Get out my rap. Oh, we killed him. Give me your good stuff. We got shark meat.